know that. I am not as drunk as last time. Last time, like, the edges of my vision were, like, blacked out.
Oh, yeah, it was terrible.
Yeah. Seriously, dude.
You should have gone back and watched it. I was like, yeah, I'm not pulling this shit. We were like, yeah, you know, Chuck Bassett.
Yeah. No, I seriously, I don't even remember doing the podcast, and that's...
We tried to get all, like, real sentimental and talk about addictions and stuff.
Did we?
Yeah, it was really bad. We're sitting there drinking, drunk as shit, going like, addictions are a serious thing. Alright, well, alright, here we go. This is the, Danzig, Mother. No, you're not supposed to sing along with him.
I messed that up already.
That's all good. It's whatever. Mother, you know why he wrote this song? No. This song was written back in like, it was like in the 90s sometime, whenever Temper Gore, whatever her name was. Yeah. She was all against music and stuff like that. And that's when Dee Snider and all. Apparently a bunch of artists made like anti censorship songs. And this is his saying like, Mother, tell your children not to walk my way. Like he's saying like, Mother, you know?
Yep.
Tipper Gore. So anyway, it's been recording for a minute. This is the Mess With Podcast. I'm Adam.
I'm Matt.
And that's... We're not doing any video this week because...
We don't have our makeup on.
I don't have my makeup on. Don't really care to. I don't know. I could show Matt every once in a while.
Our makeup artist has a flu.
Well, there I am. There's Matt. That's the only time you're going to see me.
So what do you want to talk about?
I was looking at some stuff. We go Dax Shepard. You know who that guy is?
Yeah, the husband of Christian Bell. Kristen Bell.
I thought they got a divorce. Maybe they didn't.
That was all rumors that he was cheating on her. Apparently.
Well, he said he told Dr. Phil that he once had what could maybe be called a sex addiction.
Oh.
And I'm like, if I was married to her, yeah. I would probably have a sex addiction too.
Right. So I bet he did cheat on her, and they're covering it up, but they're working on it, so they don't want the public to know. But yeah, he probably cheated.
Why would you cheat on her?
I don't know. She's amazing.
She's funny.
I mean, yeah. Okay. So everything that we see, she is literally.
But behind the scenes, she could be a bitch.
She could be, but she is funny. She's amazing looking. Funny.
You know what she isn't, though?
I don't.
Tall.
She is very short.
Yeah, she's pretty short. Let's see how short she is.
I'm going to say 5'2". 5'2". But, and then, I mean, like, I guess that's that thing. I don't know. I mean, Dax Shepard, he's a pretty handsome guy himself. I don't know why he would want to run around. But then again, you don't know. We're on the outside looking in, right?
The outside looking in. What the fuck is going on with my browser?
Not sure. Too much porn coming up?
I told you I've never watched porn on this thing.
And as well, you shouldn't. Is it still running just as fast as the day you got it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's why.
5'1".
I was close.
Yeah.
I went over. I failed by Price is Right rules.
Dax Shepard's 6'3". He's taller than us.
Yeah, he's a tall, handsome dude. Makes money. I mean, like...
And he's not funny.
Depending on what you've seen him in.
I've seen him in a lot. He has never made me laugh.
Did you watch him in Chips?
We've already gone over Chips. I'm not watching that shitty movie.
He's funny in Chips.
I'm not watching Actually, Chips.
You know what? It's more his, what is that guy's name? Miguel. It's a guy in Ant-Man. He's in a lot of stuff. And everything I've seen him in, he's super good. And I'm ashamed that I don't know his name yet. Because I've liked him in everything I've seen him in. Are you looking it up?
No, I'm wondering why I'm trying to. Whenever I try to. I'm gonna close down my browser and bring it back up. Every time I try to Google something through my browser, it's trying to make me use Yahoo, and Yahoo sucks.
Yahoo sucks. Google is the only way to go. Bing sucks. Yahoo sucks. Google.
Probably because I go to Yahoo all the time just to see the.
Stop doing that.
Well, it tells me what's going on. I don't know what's going on. Let's see. Dogs. Yeah, it's trying to make me. I'll fix
whatever.
It. I'll figure it out later.
So, we watched
we'll do it in post.
An amazing game earlier. The Saints and the Rams. Number one versus number two. You had the Saints winning. I had the Rams winning.
No.
Who won that game?
The New Jersey Red Wings.
Yes. They stepped in, said, y'all suck, we're gonna take it over from here. The New Jersey Red Wings, the NFL's most recent expansion team. Should I keep talking like this, or should I talk like Brown on the bench?
I won't make fun of that guy, man.
No, I'm not. I don't want to make fun of him, because I really
mean,
do like him.
You're a mean dude.
I really do like that guy. I really like him. He makes me laugh. He's a good commentator. I don't know what's wrong with his voice, but yeah. So it was a playoff game that everyone would hope to watch, except for that pass interference call. That shit.
Yeah, they would have won that game if they were. That should have been pass interference.
It should have been pass interference. I mean, this guy.
That was like NFL blitz. The guy before the ball.
The receiver. This Rams DB. Tackled this wide receiver right before the ball got to them, and it was a catchable ball too, and they didn't call it, and it was down in the Saints red zone, right?
Yeah.
And I just don't understand why that was not a penalty. I mean, that would have kept them in the red zone. Whether they would have scored right then, I think they would have scored after, or at least like melted the clock down more, where the Rams could not have back and won.
Yeah.
I think that changed the entire game.
I did.
And that
I mean, it put it overtime. But, I mean, the thing is they did go in overtime, and the defense Saints of the Rams did a good job. At
Saints had their chance.
They had their chance to win.
And they didn't do it. So, I guess you could argue that. That is a good argument. But
I'm going to say it's going to be the Chiefs and the Rams now.
You think the Chiefs are going to win?
Yes, I think the Chiefs are going to win.
I think the Patriots are going to win. We're going to go on record. You're going to be wrong. You're going to be 0-2, and I'm going to be 2-0 tonight.
That's fine. Be 2.
So,
Bengals interested in Jack Del Rio as DC.
That's a good call. Jack Del Rio is a good defensive coordinator. Not a good head coach. Good coordinator.
Good coordinator, so yeah. Yeah, it looks like New England's in the red zone again.
Are they really?
Yeah, it's 7-0 and then red zone again. Yep. It'll be 14-0.
See. Chiefs can they handled the first round, which is the first time in 20 years, but can they handle the next? And I don't think they can.
They might be able to.
Yeah. I don't know. I think that the experience, the strategy, or strategery,
strategery.
The Patriots is just too much.
So I'm going to read you the headline.
Yeah, read it to me.
This is in Ireland.
Ooh, in Ireland.
And okay, the thing that it says under it says doctors in Ireland didn't see this coming. It says man hospitalized after injecting own semen to treat back pain. It was a 33-year-old man after repeatedly injecting himself with semen to relieve chronic back pain.
I think the only reason that makes news is because we have so much access to information. I'm sure in the history of stupidity that's been done. I don't know why. I understand that you want to introduce stem cells to a chronic issue to maybe heal that area that doesn't get a lot of blood flow. Semen, however, will not do that. Semen has no other function than to procreate.
Yeah. Here's another one. This is out of Florida. Florida man threatens to kill neighbors with kindness.
Well,
his machete was called Kindness.
Yeah. Okay, so you can name your weapon.
He's a 30-year-old man. Brian Stewart calls machete Kindness.
So sometimes you just get so fed up.
Have you heard this, like, 10-year challenge bullshit going on?
I've seen it on Facebook. The best one I've seen it. Do you remember Alicia Timms?
No.
All right, well, girl we went to school with, I guess her younger sister did a 10-year challenge. She's a Dallas Cowboy cheerleader. That's the best one I've seen so far. Everyone else is just, like, yeah, you're there 10 years later.
Do you think it'd be in poor taste if I did a 10-year challenge with, like, Chester Bennington?
I don't know who that is.
The lead singer in Linkin Park.
Oh, it'd be funny.
It'd be him 10 years later, earlier.
In a grave.
And then a coffin.
Coffin, yeah. No, that would be funny. Dark humor. People
that's too low, man. Like, look, he killed himself. That means it's fair game.
Yeah.
In my opinion, if you kill yourself, you're fair game to get ridiculed.
Right. I mean...
You're your own tragedy.
Don't make fun of depression.
No.
Yeah. Jab at the person.
You know that I struggle with that shit. Yeah, I struggle really bad with that.
We all do.
Yeah, I struggle. I have to. I'm medicated because of it. And it's yeah. 10-year challenge.
I think the funniest 10-year challenges were I think Deadpool already beat you. Because he did a 10-year challenge for Wolverine. He showed Wolverine in the graveyard. And then he did a 10-year challenge for Colossus and then showed a shot up garbage can.
That's funny.
But.
I don't know if you ever used Tumblr.
No, but they got rid of porn recently.
Yeah, apparently there's a big outpour about that.
Because people love child porn.
Is it child porn they got rid of?
No, they got rid of porn. But I think Tumblr was a outlet for child pornography.
How did people get child porn on Tumblr?
I'm not sure, but that's the things that I've seen.
Did they not monitor that shit?
I've never looked at Tumblr. I don't know anything
about it. I had Tumblr one time because I thought it was something cool to have, and then I realized...
I don't even know what it is.
You post pictures or blog... I tried to get...
Like
Instagram? Kind of. A lot of people that draw comic strips use it.
Well.
But I quit using it because I didn't know what the fuck it was for. But when I found out they got rid of porn, I was like, wait, they had porn on that? And... I didn't know about the child porn. I mean, like, I remember I saw, like, there was every once in a while you'd see something that was not safe for work, but...
Yeah. So, I think it was an outlet for, like, people to try to, like, amateur porn-ish on there.
Well, it says they're betraying the sex workers and not safe for work artists who rely on the program, or the platform. Yeah. So, I guess people are mad about that.
So you know what they should do? Find a programmer and could make a not safe for work app, and then they could do whatever they want to do on that.
Well, if they're putting child porn on there, I guess, yeah, it makes sense. Are they getting with, like, this is a 19-year-old girl that looks like she's 15 porn?
I'm not sure. Most of my information came from Twitter, came from Reddit, and it just dealt with porn. I think maybe I saw a child porn once. Whether I didn't literally see it. I saw an article like saying,
"Oh, yeah."
Never actually seen that. I'm gonna go on record. I've never seen it. I don't want to. But they had something. There was a big outrage because of that. Oh. And that their viewership or something has dropped dramatically.
Well, yeah, you took out the porn.
Yeah.
How about this one? British model turned pieces of her labia into designer jewelry.
I mean, that's the meat curtain.
Yeah.
Do they really need that?
She made a necklace out of it.
Well, do you want to wear that?
I mean, I don't know.
You would want to wear that.
Maybe.
Maybe. This is somebody's pussy on my neck.
Oh, gross! No, UFC fighter loses control of her bowels but keeps a good sense about it. Yeah, she
pooped?
She there's poop all over the ring. You don't look at it?
No.
Yeah, she pooped. I'm a warrior. I'll never quit. Shit happens. Ha ha. Be back soon.
So she was fighting.
And she pooped.
When she was like grappling?
Or yeah, she was gonna grab. Well, like it was like they're on top of it, and then they rolled over, and you just saw shit stains on the damn.
Literally putting everything out there.
Yeah, shit happens, I guess. That's real cool.
So what did they do with the mat? Did they bleach it? Did anybody fight after that?
I didn't want to read anymore.
Oh, okay.
Doctor removes wedding ring from man's penis. That's a good one.
Like, he wrapped it, like, put it on his dick.
28-year-old South African endured a rare case of penile strangulation. I'm trying to read and I'm drinking. After squeezing his right ring around his sex organ for exotic reasons. How small does your wiener have to be to put... I have pretty big hands. But I couldn't put the ring that would fit my fattest finger and my thumb still wouldn't fit on my hoo-ha.
Not a hoo-ha. Hoo-ha is pussy.
Oh, my uncle pleaser.
Dick.
Now I'm going to call it my uncle pleaser.
Your uncle pleaser? Yeah. I'm not really sure how that happened. Or why? I mean, maybe he had a vibrating ring.
Why would you have a vibrating ring?
I don't know. I'm just trying to, like, think of reasons as to why you would put a ring around your dick. I mean, he would have to stuff that shit like a Christmas turkey.
Well, there was... I know there's been a lot of things where people put their dicks in beer bottles.
Wait,
I just,
what?
Yeah.
In there?
Yeah.
I would never.
I couldn't either. And I'm not even packing.
I mean, like, literally, that's...
Like, I'm not even bragging. Like, I'm probably...
That's micro.
If anything, someone goes like, I'm either average or a little below, but man, I know that my dick could not fit into, or my uncle pleaser could not fit into a beer bottle.
Yeah.
I mean, I would have to, like... I don't know what I have to do.
I don't know, but I think that's weird. That's a weird story, and we should move on.
Let's see.
Did you visit Little Big Town?
No, that's when Ian bought them guitars, they give us some guitar picks. There was a story I read about where this guy's going to prison. It was on the Reddit subreddit, I'm a Total Piece of Shit. And he's going to prison because he was telling people they had cancer when they didn't, so he could get money off their chemo.
A doctor?
Uh-huh.
Damn.
Yeah.
He should go to prison.
For at least a day or two, yeah.
To figure out the thing. A day or two. Let him go and he can do it again.
Sure, that Van Dyke guy is going to prison for the guy, the cop that shot that kid?
Yeah.
Yeah, finally. One of them go to prison.
Yeah, he shot him. Black kid, right?
The kid had a knife, but you didn't need to shoot him.
I mean, No. You're taught in the military use of deadly force, and there's levels. And if somebody, I mean, I think if somebody's coming after you with a knife intending to end your life, then yeah, you shoot.
There's video of it.
I haven't seen
any. He was way away from the cop, and the cop just has his gun out and goes, and then you just see the kid getting shot, and you go,
then if you, yeah, you shoot him if they're coming, like, charging.
Yeah, he wasn't doing that.
Okay.
So.
All right.
So what have you been up to? Since we didn't skip last week, but I just, or yeah. I'm just not uploading that one.
Was that
or the week before last?
I was going to say last week. I don't, like, shit. What was I doing last week?
Technically, it's been like, what the hell's on my?
I think 2 weeks. Yeah, it was. Wait. I don't know.
I actually opened Stardew Valley.
Who?
Stardew Valley.
I don't know what that is.
It's a video game made by people. Let's. So, anything new since then?
No. No, nothing. I live a very uneventful life.
Yeah, I went to your. I finally saw your place today. I haven't seen it.
Yeah, what'd you think? It was pretty amazing, right?
Bachelor pad, like motherfucker.
Yeah. Couch.
A TV that's barely on its stand and.
Wait, what?
I don't know. Just no. He has milk crates and a cardboard and a thing.
That's
yeah, exactly thing of plywood.
No, nothing on the walls. It's not very homey. It's a couch, TV in the living room, and then a bed and a TV.
I can see why you like hanging out over here.
I mean, yeah.
This place is a little bit more homey. Plus, I got a bigger couch. I got your old couch.
Yeah, you do have my own couch. Yeah, no, the only good thing about my house right now is my dog. And that's mobile. Except you won't let me bring my dog over here.
No, the dog doesn't even like me. Why would I want him to come over here?
It needs to get to know you.
Unless it goes by the word godsend, I don't even know it.
If I called it godsend, can we bring it over?
We'll get it to answer to godsend, and we'll talk about it.
All
right. So you watched, how many episodes of The Punisher did you watch?
I think I'm on episode 5 right now.
Fuck. I only watched the first one. It was pretty good.
It's good, dude. John Bernthal, like, okay, the only thing I don't like about him is that if you ask me a question, this is how he reacts every single time. like,
yeah, that is true.
Like, he, I mean, every single question, he reacts the same. So, but I get, like, everything else about him and enveloping that character definitely overwhelms that aspect. Like,
well, they say whenever
I notice that every single time.
Well, they also say that whenever if someone that doesn't trust anyone, they don't look anybody straight in the eyes.
Yeah, but he did that. I think he did that in Walking Dead as well.
When he was Shane.
Yeah,
he's a much better Frank Castle than a Shane.
He's a much better. And if they brought, like, okay, so there are two actors. Actually, I think the Netflix series perfectly picked every single one of their characters.
Except for
Danny Rand.
Fuck those.
That guy's so God. Ass.
I didn't even watch the second season.
It's better than the first, but still sucks.
You watched it?
Yeah.
Gotcha. No. I was hoping that the reason I didn't watch it is why they canceled it. I was like, wait, Adam didn't watch it?
No.
Get rid of that shit.
Cole, or the guy that played Luke Cage, perfect. The guy that played Charlie Cox.
They got another season of Jessica Jones coming out, too.
Perfect. Jessica Ritter, something Ritter. She's good.
There's a new series of comics with her where she gives birth to the Purple Man's kid.
I saw that, and that's weird.
Well, he...
But he raped her, so...
Yeah, they didn't really talk about it much in the show.
Yeah. No, she said, I think, twice in the entire series that she was raped.
And you know what happened? Like, they finally got a hold of him, like these other superheroes, and they had no idea who she was. That's why she, like, started drinking so much and everything.
Yeah, the Purple Man is a perfect psychological villain.
Then you got Kitty Pryde.
What?
From the second season. Her friend that gets injected with that stuff that gives her, like...
That's not Kitty Pryde.
I mean, not Kitty Pryde. God, what the fuck is her name?
I can see her outfit.
It's Cat something. Something to do with Cat, goddammit.
She's Mystic. I've actually played as a Heroclix with her.
It's going to drive me crazy.
Yeah. No. It's Colossus' girlfriend who can go through walls. Shadow Cat. I could think of it as like Panther or something like that, but it's not it. You're gonna say it. It's gonna fucking
Hellcat.
Hellcat. Yeah. Okay.
Hellcat.
Yeah. Or devilish pussy.
What?
That's better. Anywho.
I watched Monty Python's and the Holy Grail for the first time ever.
So you just watched it a week ago? I watched it for the first time 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
And all my life, I've heard nothing but praise for this movie.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's like the pinnacle, the like, oh my god, yeah. It's the movie of comedies. And that, who told me that? A bunch of old people.
Yeah.
In 1970, whatever it came out of, yes, that would have cracked my shit up. Watching it now, so there was a scene that I was waiting for you to watch. I even told you before we even started. It was the scene with Lancelot.
Yeah. Right? That was really funny.
It was one of the funniest scenes I have seen ever.
Yeah.
I loved that scene. And they hit it right on the nail. Most of the movie was rather bland.
Yeah, it was a lot of banter. Just like, why do you say no? We're the Knights of Zap.
Yeah, the Knights of Knee were kind of
no. Now we're not called that anymore. It's like, okay, and it's like, I mean, I can see where Family Guy got their fucking humor from because they're just beating the dead horse with it.
Yeah,
I'm like the whole thing with the coconuts and the sparrow. I was like, okay, we get it.
Yeah,
we get it.
So, but there was this one scene where Lancelot is charging. All right, so he receives an arrow that gives him a mission, and he is charging this castle. These two guards are sitting there watching him charge the castle, and all of a sudden he's set back, or how do you describe that? He's reset, basically.
Yeah.
Back to his original position. So Lancelot's charging this castle, and all of a sudden he's reset. 100 yards. And
yeah.
And the guards are like, huh? And then he's like, I'm coming at you. Then he gets reset again. The guards are like, huh? And then he resets again. And then all of a sudden, bam.
Yeah.
He is at the guards, stabbing one of the guards.
It's right here. All the guards are wearing feathers on their head. You guys just sitting there eating.
That's your drums.
It's running, yeah. They keep putting him further back. I didn't even notice that.
Yeah.
Oh my god. I didn't know what was going to happen when I saw this thing. I was like, all right, let's see.
And all of a sudden. It's one of the funniest scenes I've seen in comedy.
Ever. Yeah.
And then he goes through the castle, just annihilating everybody. Kicks the bride in the he runs up to the person that he thinks he is rescuing, who is this just, in the 70s, a very womanly man who is supposed to be the prince, the dad, you know, is not happy. This kid is his son. And then the dialogue between the king and the owner of the castle and Lancelot is even hilarious. Then it's like,
yeah,
you just killed everybody. He's like, oh, sorry.
Sorry. And they're
like, I got it up. He's like, well, yeah, you know, like, come marry, like, come look at this, and then we'll marry this person.
Well, knowing, so I wanted to do some research on it because I just watched it. And here's a crazy fact about Monty Python. I'm sure a lot of people know, but I didn't know. And the Holy Grail. That movie, no one would pick it up. No production companies.
Yep.
And Led Zeppelin, Pink Floyd, Death Row Troll, and I've heard Elton John also threw money to fund the entire fucking movie.
The entire thing. And
they called it a great tax write-off.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah. Isn't that crazy? And that sparked a career for, I mean, mostly John Cleese is the person that we all know.
Yeah. I mean, I thought that was interesting. Interesting stuff. But yeah, I finally watched it. It's decent. I don't know if I'll ever watch it again because
I won't ever watch it again. But that
scene. That scene was. Well, and also because of Kung Pao.
Yeah.
That's one of the funniest movies, in my opinion, ever made. And that scene was Peter Pan, Shmee. I mean, that movie. I gotta watch it. We have to watch that movie again.
We do need to watch it again. But yes, that scene was directly stolen.
Oh yeah, just straight.
From Monty Python.
Yeah. So like I said, we were just trying to put out a podcast tonight. It's been about 30 minutes. I'm ready to end this. We didn't really set up too much on it. Just wanted to put something out there so you guys could laugh with us or at us. I don't give a shit. But you got anything going on next Sunday?
I have nothing. Let's do this again. I'll try to get Austin with us.
Yeah, we got a buddy that wants to come and try this out. And he wants to be part of this, and I'm all up for everybody want to be part of it. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, I think Austin would definitely bring a different perspective. Two, he's a great conversationalist. Every time I've ever talked to that guy, he has something to add to the conversation. Never a bad conversation, basically.
Oh yeah, and I've known that guy for him and I'm
longer than I have.
Yeah,
he's my brother.
Yeah, I knew him before he was married or even started dating your sister. Yeah,
so I think that would be a good addition. I will text him. Let's do this next Sunday.
Yeah. Austin, if you're listening to this, you better be ready.
Punk-ass bitch.
We usually do it around 7, but we're going to go finish the game.
Punk-ass bitch.
How can fitness designed for everyone be the right fit for you?
Why would it be the right fit for anyone? So, we're going to finish this off with some more dancing. So, anyways, this has been the podcast. We've had fun. You've had fun. Everybody's had fun. Matt, you got any parting words for anyone?
No.
All right, remember to spade and neuter your kids, and I'll see you guys later.